I used to think that I could not go on, and life was nothing but an awful song. But now I know the meaning of true love. I'm leaning on I just believe it. There's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. See, I was on the verge of breaking down. Sometimes silence can seem so loud. But first I know it starts inside of me. Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can be it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Hey, 'cause I believe in you. Oh, if I can see it, then I can do it.
Thank you all for coming tonight to help us celebrate these young people that have worked hard in their chosen areas, and for all of our instructors that have worked tirelessly with them. Parents, we do salute you as well as your child, because we know beside every great child there's a great parent probably pushing them and pulling them, but they get the job done. At this time, we are going to ask Mrs. Renee Huff, the Director of Career and Technical Education, to come and bring us our welcome. Following that, we will have the superintendent's remarks, Dr. Serency, and then we will have our keynote speaker. But after the welcome, I am going to recognize our dignitaries that are here tonight.
Good evening, everyone. This is a favorite time of the year for me as we honor our students in our CTE programs. At this time, I would like to recognize all of our CTE teachers that are here this evening. Would you please stand? Thank you for all you do for our students. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to hear about the many accomplishments of the students that have been nominated for CTE Superstars of their chosen program of study. The Putnam County School District CTE programs offer the promise of employment, career advancement, and the security of earning a family sustainable income. Just a little note, in 2016-17, approximately 250 industry certification exams were taken by the students in our programs. And 180 of them passed their exams. These exams help the students to be able to go into the workforce or begin their post-secondary studies. Congratulations, students and teachers. This year, we have had good accomplishment in our CTE programs. We added a welding program at Interlochen High School, and we've also added advanced manufacturing technology in our schools. We hope to be able to grow those programs in the next several years. Now, I have no doubt that these CTE superstars we honor tonight have a bright future ahead of them. I would like to introduce my staff this evening, because if it wasn't for them, I couldn't put this on. My executive secretary is Patty Smith. Our career education facilitator that's new to us this year is Ms. Nikki Gill. And our CTE career specialist, Ms. Janet Cobble. Sit back and enjoy this evening. Thank you.
At this time, I'm honored to present our distinguished guests. We have Putnam County Commissioner, Mr. Chip Leibel. We have our property appraiser, Mr. Tim Parker. We have our supervisor of elections, Mr. Charles Overturf III. We have our tax collector, Mrs. Linda Myers. All right, before I introduce the board members and those that are seated here at the head table, are there any other elected officials that may have come in after we had taken the list? Anyone else? Okay. At this time, we will introduce my right. On the far end, we have Mrs. Nikki Cummins. Board member. We have Mrs. Kathy Jorgensen, board member. We have Mrs. Jane Crawford, our chairperson of the school board. And of course, you have met Mrs. Huff, our director of the CTE program. Here on my left, starting immediately right there beside me, will be our guest speaker, Mr. McClellan. We have the superintendent of Putnam County Schools, Dr. Rick Serency. And we have board member, Mr. David Buckles. Now, we would be remiss if we did not acknowledge the administrative staff here at Palatka High School. Mr. J.T. Stout is our principal. We have assistant principal, Mrs. Michelle Tucker. Okay, I think I saw Mrs. Charisse Williams. She's our dean. Did I get it correct, Charisse? Okay. All right. Where's Michael? All right, Mr. Michael Chairs. Okay, he's a TOSA, teach on special assignment. We have Mrs. Pamela Brown. She is one of our coaches for the district. Also, I know I saw Mrs. France. Okay, all right, Mrs. Laura France. She's associate superintendent from Crescent City High. We have Dr. Shelby. Any others? I don't want to leave out anyone. You are all equally important to it. Don't hide. Come on now. Oh, Miss Tanya Whitehurst, yes. She's a director of staff services. Human resources, yes, yes. Okay. Anyone else? I do not want to omit anyone. And yours truly, Sandra Gillian. Okay. At this time, we will have our remarks from the superintendent. Following that, we will have our keynote speaker, Mr. Jerry McClellan.
Thank you, Ms. Gilliard. It's a pleasure to be here, and I'm very excited for these young people. They work very hard to be here, and I'm so proud of what they've done over their time in our high schools. And I tell you, it's such a great feeling to know these students can leave here with skills to go to work and earn a high-paying career position. So we're very excited about that. Isn't it nice to have kids grow up and pay taxes and start to support us for a change, right? So. Yeah, so that's what we're about. We want to raise kids, have them get a good job, and stay home, stay here in Putnam County so they can support us, and we're very happy with that. I just want to thank a few other people. There's a number of guidance counselors out here in the audience, and I'm just going to ask our guidance counselors please stand, if you would, and be recognized. And not many of you know why guidance counselors are so important, because they are the ones who schedule our students in their classes. And it is a challenge to make sure those kids stay in those programs and earn that certification, because it's very easy to find another class to put them in, but those counselors make them stay with that program, and that's why so many of these kids are here now, is because their guidance counselors, as well as their CTE teachers, have stuck with them and made it possible for them to be successful. And again, I want to thank a few other people. Parents, I can't thank you enough, number one, for being here and for supporting your students along the way, especially when they get discouraged. Maybe they think about dropping out of the program and doing something else, but you're there to encourage them, so they couldn't do it without you. And again, thank you, students. You know, it's really important that you stick it out. There's been a lot of challenges, you know, through your high school career, but you've now shown potential employers that you can persevere, you can survive, and you can earn that industry certification, and you're employable now. And that means a lot. To have that certificate in your hand makes you a valuable commodity in our community. So thank you for your time. I do want to, I'd be remiss without saying, our business community offers so much for our career and technical education programs. We've had some businesses that have actually given us grants to buy equipment to start programs. And I won't mention those businesses now because I'll leave somebody out. But with their time and their money and their efforts and their mentorship, we could not do it without our business community stepping up and partnering with the school district to make this happen. I want to thank our local government officials. Many of them are here today, you know, for just being supportive, you know, helping to partner with the district to make sure our career and technical education programs are a priority in our community. I tell you, if our economy is going to improve, it's going to be because skilled workers are going to be trained, they're going to get high-paying jobs, and we're going to support our businesses. It's all one big partnership. So thank you to our local government officials. And I also want to thank our state legislators. This past year, we actually received $250,000 grant from the state legislature towards funding our career and technical education programs. And that's a huge lift with so many things being deleted or cut out by the governor. He was able to recognize that our district is doing something very positive to create jobs. So we received that money, and part of that was because some of our local businesses were willing to do a match. They gave us money to show they are committed to seeing Putnam County grow career-wise and train a strong workforce. So our state legislature is going to, you know, give us support to move ahead. But still, we have a long ways to go, but these students right here are an integral part of helping Putnam County. And next year, you know, we're going to continue that as we try to match careers with what our workforce needs. You know, we're trying to stay in touch with the Chamber of Commerce. We're getting information. Our advanced manufacturing program, our welding program, our business program, so many of these programs that Ms. Huff mentioned, we just don't come up with these off the cuff. These are needs that our county have. And we're going to see our county continue to grow. We've seen our graduation rate grow by 17 points over the last 2 years, which is the highest growth of any district in the state. And next year, we're anticipating an even further growth. And you know, part of that is because kids see that school is relevant. They want to graduate. They want to graduate on time. And you're going to see our graduation rate continue to improve because we are now making learning relevant, and kids can leave school and get meaningful jobs. So thanks to all of you. It's a pleasure to be here. And congratulations again to our students. Thank you.
Well, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. That's a little better. I've learned one thing already. They throw this word keynote speaker around pretty loosely. Ain't that right, Patty? Patty and I are kinfolk, go back a long ways. Is that all right? Can you hear me? Again, we're here tonight to celebrate some hard work and accomplishments of our CTE superstars. Seminole Electric is honored to recognize our superstars for excelling in their areas of interest and study. On behalf of Seminole, we commend you and your dedication and your achievements. Seminole Electric understands the importance of growing our workforce to fill positions in Putnam County and in our hometown. Employees who have helped their county to continue to strive and grow in the years to come. Career ed programs that teach the necessary skills for these kids and students to have successful lives in years to come. Technical programs across our country have declined, or technical programs across the country have declined in educational systems and have focused on four-year university degrees through the years. This focus has left a large workforce shortage in technical fields. And from my responsibilities within SECI, I have felt firsthand difficulties of filling vacancies in technical fields. It's hard to come by. People that want to apply themselves in the technical areas. Many are running to, are going to colleges pursuing four-year degrees, and there's quite a opportunity for kids nowadays who are willing to enter the technical field. Again, what does that mean for you? It means the job market's wide open nowadays. For you, it means an increase in opportunities for job placement and earning a potential which may turn into even greater opportunities. And tonight I'd like to speak from my heart just a minute to share with you an experience or some opportunities that with a young man that graduated from this high school 35 years ago can tell you about. 35 years ago, he was walking these hallways. And after a short stint in the military, 4 years to be a matter of fact, it probably didn't seem all that short at the time, he wound up marrying his high school sweetheart, and the young couple decided to settle right here in his hometown of Palatka. In 1988, with a very limited opportunities of employment that provided the work benefits that they were searching for, he set a goal of gaining employment at either GP or Seminole Electric. Now, realizing the competitive employment obstacles that he faced, he chose to pursue a career in a technical field that would provide the greatest opportunity for him to realize this goal. So he applied and was accepted for a 5-year electrical apprenticeship program. Just before graduating, in May of 1993, he began submitting his applications to both companies. Just ahead of him graduating, the young man was offered and accepted a position at Georgia Pacific. A goal that he had set 5 years earlier was realized. But 70 days later, just ahead of his probationary period ending at GP, he was offered and accepted a position at Seminole Electric. another goal realized, all because of his technical schooling and background that he had chose. Through the years, he's had the blessing to work alongside of great team members who have afforded him the opportunity to continue his education while gaining technical and valuable life experience. In March of this year, he and his wife celebrated 31 years of marriage, and in May of this year, he will celebrate 25 years of service at SGS, where he is presently serving as the manager of plant operations, all enabled, empowered by technical education. Another note, and I would like you to listen real close, young people. These goals were not realized overnight. And so often in today's world, we expect what we want and we want it quickly and overnight. But whether these goals were achieved through time, through drive, through determination, hard work, and a desire to succeed, and all founded on beliefs, character, a technical education, and attitude. Yes, attitude. And I want to close with this. I would like to share with you a belief that was shared with me many years ago. A belief penned by Charles Swindoll. He said, "The longer I live, the more I realize the impact of attitude on life. Attitude to me is more important than facts. It is more important than the past, the education, the money, the circumstances. It's more important than failure, than successes, than whatever people think, say, or do. It is more important than appearance, giftedness, or skill. Attitude will make or break a company, a church, or a home. The remarkable thing is we have a choice every day regarding the attitude we will embrace for that day. We cannot change our past. We cannot change the fact that people will act in a certain way. We cannot change the inevitable. The only thing we can do is play on the one string that we have. And that is our attitude. I am convinced that life is 10% what happens to me and 90% how I react to it. I would add respond, because there's a difference between reacting and responding. Reacting is out of emotion. Response is well thought of and carried out. And so it is with you. We, all of us in this room, are in charge of our attitudes. So on behalf of Seminole Electric, I want to congratulate our students, their teachers, and their family and friends for supporting and encouraging their growth and development. Tonight is the evening of celebration, and we thank you for being here. Now please join me in celebrating our CTE superstars.
As Mr. McClellan makes his way down, he and Superintendent Cernsey, to present the awards, I will share with you information that each of our superstars have written regarding themselves and their goals. And before we get started with that, again, we all celebrate you tonight, and we're proud of your efforts. Our first nominee, Veronica Battles, Accounting Operations, Palatka High School. Veronica's accomplishment in the field of career and technical education include being employed with the ViStar Credit Union branch at the high school, being awarded Employee of the Quarter at ViStar Credit Union, maintaining AB Honor Roll, and participating in many community service activities. While in high school, she has managed and volunteered with the sports and flag football program. Veronica's hobbies include traveling, and watching basketball. She has earned over 250 community service hours where she participates in Keep Putnam Beautiful and volunteering for the concession stand for the Paris Sports Program. She is currently student manager intern with VyStar. Outside of high school, Veronica is the president for Delta Gems Academy. She participates in Palatka Police Athletic League as a youth in the development mentoring program, and she is the vice president of her class for jobs for Florida graduates. She attends To God Be the Glory Holiness Church. After graduation, Veronica plans to attend Bethune-Cookman University, where she will study business administration. Veronica is the daughter of Earl and LaTanya Battles. Ladies and gentlemen, Veronica Battles. Our next nominee, April Munoz, Administrative Office Specialist, Crescent City High School. April's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include achieving her Microsoft Office certification, balancing her work with extracurricular activities, and achieving excellence in both, and being inducted into the National Honor Society. Outside of school, her biggest accomplishments have been taking on a leadership role in a church that is traditionally male-dominated. April's hobbies include working with the youth in her community, playing musical instruments, and helping others be successful. While in school, April participated in band, drumline, student council, NHS, beta, and dual enrollment. She also took on many leadership roles. She has been the drum major of the high school band for 3 years, president of the National Honor Society, and youth leader at her church. After graduation, April plans to complete her AA degree at St. John's River State College. Then she would like to transfer to the University of North Florida and pursue a bachelor's degree in elementary education with a minor in music. April is the daughter of Maria Munoz and Nathaniel Perez. Ladies and gentlemen, April Munoz. Tamaya Charles, Administrative Office Specialist, Palatka High School. Tamaya's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include receiving her 2010 Microsoft certification in PowerPoint, Word, Outlook, Excel, and Access. Her 2016 Microsoft certification in PowerPoint, Outlook, Word, and Excel, her My Florida Ready to Work Silver credential, and completing her Administrative Office Specialist degree. While in school, she also accomplished running for Miss Weska and winning that title. She has been raising money for scholarships for Miss Weska. Tamaya's hobbies include cooking, reading, and praise dancing. While in school, she participated in the basketball cheerleading, Starlight Elite, and the Paw Print, which is the school newspaper, for 2 years. She has also taken on a leadership role by mentoring other students in her classes and activities. After graduation, Tamaya would like to obtain her AA in Business Administration from St. John's River State College, then her BA in Business Administration from a university. She would like to intern for a top corporation and become a financial advisor for a major company or open her own business. Tamaya is the daughter of Jan Davis and Tori Childs. Ladies and gentlemen, Tamaya Childs. Brianna Dowdy, Administrative Office Specialist, Interlochen High School. Brianna's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include exhibiting leadership skills by maintaining a positive attitude, good attendance, and maintaining A's in all of her classes. Throughout high school, Brianna has participated in Interact, Culinary Arts, and Administrative Office Assistance. She feels her biggest accomplishment in high school have been maintaining a high GPA, having good attendance all through high school, and acquiring good typing skills. Brianna's hobbies include reading, typing, and being with friends. After graduation, she plans to obtain her AA degree and then transfer to a university where she will major in elementary education and become a teacher. Brianna is the daughter of Kevin and Amy Leong. Ladies and gentlemen, Brianna Dowdy. Scott Nemec, Advanced Manufacturing, Interlochen High. Scott's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include participating in the first advanced manufacturing course at Interlochen High. While attending Interlochen, he has also participated in Junior ROTC, where he has received multiple medals and went to state to compete with the Junior ROTC Raiders team. Scott says welding has challenged him by teaching him new things along the way. Welding has taught him more about the importance of completing projects. He was the co-leader of the JROTC Raiders team, where he was responsible for handling the team, promoting general morale, and dealing with the organization of their events. After graduation, he plans to go to Santa Fe to complete the basics of welding. He then would like to pursue a job in welding and obtain his certified welding license. Scott is the son of Lori and Brian Nemec. Jared Atkins, Advanced Manufacturing, Palatka High. Jared's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include maintaining a 4.0 GPA his freshman year of high school and completing his first year in advanced manufacturing technology. Jared's hobbies include spending time on streaming services, organizing, and playing his clarinet. While in school this year, he has participated with the Palatka High Marching Band. After graduation, Jared would like to go to a vocational school or join an apprenticeship program to become an electrician or electrical engineer. Jared is the son of April and Jim Dowdery and Joseph Atkins. Thank you, Mr. Stout, for accepting. Jasmine Altmeyer, Agriculture Education, Crescent City High School. Jasmine's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include being able to participate in animal science and working with different animals, all while maintaining good grades and attendance. Jasmine says being nominated for this award is one of the biggest achievements she has. Jasmine's hobbies include cleaning, grooming, and feeding the different animals and their pens and cages. Her biggest accomplishment outside of school is getting a job that allows her to get on the right track. She said Mrs. Oakwood at Crescent City Kennel has been her biggest influence in wanting to become a vet. After graduation, she would like to attend college and obtain a master's so that she can teach English at the college level. She would also like to become a part-time vet and take care of all sorts of animals. It is her dream to go to college and complete her degree. Jasmine is the daughter of Billy Johannan and Adam Cox. Ladies and gentlemen, Jasmine Altmeyer. Travis Stanley, Agriculture Education, Palatka High School. Travis's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include Star Chapter Green Hand Award, FFA Annual Alumni Outstanding Student Award for 2 years, QI Roberts Outstanding FFA Member, 5th place in the state of Florida horse judging, 5th place in the state of Florida livestock judging, 9th place individual in state of Florida livestock judging, 3rd place in Jacksonville Fair livestock judging, placing at the Putnam County Fair Swine Show, 1st place in soil and water conservation speech contest, 3-time Scholar Athlete Award, 3rd place in FFA Creed Speaking, and Outstanding Senior Award. While in school, Travis has obtained most of his AA credit through dual enrollment. While on breaks from school, he has participated in mission trips where he has helped the underprivileged. During class, he was able to help contribute by picking up feed for the animals, feeding up on the ag farm, and helping around the farm. Travis's hobbies include hunting, fishing, baseball, and showing animals. While in school, Travis was active in FFA. He was on the baseball team for 4 years, honor guard, and dual enrollment program participant. Travis says his biggest influence for his love of ag are Sally Becker and Alexis Tilton. Under their leadership, he has held the position of secretary and treasurer. He has served as both president and vice president of his 4-H club, Boots and Bows 4-H. While on the Putnam County 4-H County Council, he has held the position of parliamentarian and inspirational thought leader. During the last 3 summers, he has served as a camp counselor at 4-H Camp Cherry Lake and a counselor in training in Ocala for 1 year. The past 5 years, he has participated in team effort missions, which allowed him to feed the homeless and the underprivileged, as well as build wheelchair ramps, repair and re-roof homes, and other household repairs. Travis has completed all of these accomplishments while working a job at Tractor Supply Company. After graduation, Travis would like to become a large animal vet and return to Putnam County to serve his community. He plans to finish his AA at St. John's River State College in the fall of 2018. Then he plans to transfer to the University of Florida to finish his degree and becoming a veterinarian. He plans to work through college at a vet's office to give him the experience needed to be a large animal vet. Travis is the son of Joe and Amy Stanley. Ladies and gentlemen, Travis Stanley, a very busy young man. Kelsey Smiley, Agriculture Education, Palatka High School. Kelsey's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include being an animal science for 3 years member, earning 3 awards for livestock judging, being academically at the top of her class, winning grand champion swine her freshman year at the Putnam County Fair, and heavyweight division champion her sophomore year. Outside of school, her biggest accomplishment is growing as a leader through life lessons and maintaining honor roll during these trials and tribulations. Kelsey's hobbies include raising swine for the county fair, volunteering for community events, and listening to music. Kelsey has been active in FFA for the last 7 years, and during this time, she's held the position of president, vice president, and she helped to collect canned goods for Feed the Need of Putnam County. She has been active in student council, pep rallies, student fundraising, sporting events, homecoming, prom, and SWAT. She was the president of SWAT for 2 years and attended many social events, fundraisers, festivals, and conventions to help raise awareness of the danger of tobacco and the influence it has on teens. After graduation, she plans to attend St. John's River State College and then transfer to the University of South Florida to receive a major in health science. Then she would like to be accepted into the University of Florida dental program. Her ultimate goal is to become a dental hygienist for children. Kelsey is the daughter of Michael Smiley and Maureen Mitchell. Ladies and gentlemen, Kelsey Smiley. Caitlin Blackmer, Agriculture Education, Interlochen High. Caitlin's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include being involved in her chapter FFA, being president of the chapter for 2017-18 school year. She is also a member of the Junior Cattlemen's Youth Advisory Committee, where she takes on the leadership role. She has won several awards showing her cattle at the Putnam County Fair under her FFA chapter. Caitlin's hobbies include showing and learning about cattle. Her passion is raising cattle to show in the county fair each year. After graduation, Caitlin plans to get her AA degree from St. John's River State College. Then she plans to transfer to Warner University and earn her bachelor's in agriculture. Upon graduating, she then would like to return to Putnam County and teach agriculture in our schools. She says, "Ag is one thing I love and will keep striving for every day, and to be able to teach the next generation about ag is my main goal." Caitlin is the daughter of Melissa and Aaron Whittington. Ladies and gentlemen, Caitlin Blackmer. Anayeli Baltazar, Allied Health Assistants, Crescent City High School. Anayeli's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include earning her certification in EKG technician, certified medical administrative assistant, Florida Ready to Work Gold credential, and certified BLS provider by the American Heart Association. Anayeli says her biggest accomplishment in school is being in the top percent of her graduating class. Outside of school, her biggest accomplishment has been scoring the winning goal at her soccer team in the final during the season at South Putnam Youth Soccer. Anayeli's hobbies include soccer and music. In her spare time, she enjoys playing and assisting with soccer. She has participated in various HOSA outreach projects, fundraising, and directing the Crescent City High Life South HOSA Blood Drive, playing for the varsity soccer team, volunteering at the Catfish Festival, and providing assistance at her church with tutoring programs. After graduation, Anayeli plans to transfer to either the University of North Florida or the University of South Florida on a scholarship to obtain her BSN as a registered nurse. She would then like to work as an RN in the neonatal intensive care unit at a hospital. Her ultimate goal is to obtain her doctorate in nursing. Anayeli is the daughter of Maria Luga. Ladies and gentlemen, Anayeli Baltazar. Grace Prince, Allied Science Assistant, Palatka High School. Grace's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include becoming a basic health care worker, obtaining her Microsoft Word and PowerPoint certification, CPR and AED certified, all A's for 3 years in her health science courses, and CTE Superstar nomination. Grace has also accomplished receiving top scholar her freshman year, maintaining her GPA above a 4.0, and successfully competing on her sports teams. Completing her clinical rotation this year has confirmed that her heart lies in the medical field. Grace's hobbies include swimming, deer hunting, and offshore fishing, being involved with her church, doing service projects for the community, and spending time with her family. Grace is currently in the health science program on the Palatka High School swim team and the archery teams. She's president of the Junior Student Council. She was a sophomore class president and freshman class vice president. She is active in the following clubs: Beta, National Honor Society, Interact, and the National Society of High School Scholars. This year, she participated in the dual enrollment program. While participating on the swim team, she has made it to regional level for 3 years. Grace took third place for the 10th grade girls at the state archery competition, where her sophomore year, she competed at the national level the last 5 years. After graduation, Grace plans to attend the University of Florida to receive a bachelor's degree in health science. Then she would like to apply to the physician assistant program to obtain her master's degree. Her goal is to make a difference in people's lives and to positively impact their health by improving it. Grace is the daughter of Kelly and Cliff Prince. Ladies and gentlemen, Grace Prince. Jasmine Monahan, Allied Health Assistant at Interlochen High. Jasmine's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include being in health classes for the past 3 years, becoming president of HOSA this year. Jasmine has maintained good grades while taking the initiative to learn more each year in health. After graduation, Jasmine plans to finish obtaining her CNA license. Then she will pursue her LPN license and continue on to become a registered nurse. Jasmine says her biggest accomplishment so far is going to college and taking the CNA program. Jasmine is the daughter of Amanda Cowley and Michael Monahan. Ladies and gentlemen, Jasmine Monahan. Ashante Watson, criminal justice, Interlochen High. Ashante's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include having the highest GPA in Criminal Justice Academy, winning top marksmanship of the year in both stationary and moving shooting drills on the laser range, and being top in her class on crime scene investigation techniques and lifting latent fingerprints. Ashante's hobbies include swimming, traveling, and athletics. While participating and excelling in volleyball, basketball, and track, Ashante excelled in the classroom as well. After graduation, Ashante would like to attend college and receive a degree in sports management that would allow her to work in the front office of a college or professional sports program. Ashante is the daughter of Cynthia Roper and Anthony Watson. Ladies and gentlemen, Ashante Watson. Peyton Wells, Culinary Arts, Palatka High School. Peyton's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include maintaining an A average all year in the culinary class and receiving the highest score in knife skill testing. His biggest accomplishment is maintaining a 4.8 the entire year and passing the 10th grade FSA in 9th grade with a level 5. His biggest personal accomplishment is successfully teaching himself to play 10 different instruments. Peyton's hobbies include being in the marching band, playing multiple musical instruments, recording music, woodworking, and enjoying the process of cooking. Peyton also takes on being a leader in his culinary class, and he's comfortable with starting and organizing projects to be completed. He loves helping others and helping them be productive in class while reaching a goal. He tutors students in Spanish and geometry as well. After graduation, Peyton would like to attend Emory Riddle's Aeronautics University and pursue a degree in aeronautics. Peyton is the son of Jody and Cindy Wells. Ladies and gentlemen, Peyton Wells. Jenna Hansford, Digital Photography, Palatka High School. Jenna's accomplishment in the field of career and technical education include 2013 Adobe Photoshop certification, 2016 Microsoft Office Word certification, 2016 Adobe Photoshop certification, and receiving blue and red ribbon awards in the Fine Arts Division of the 2016 County Fair. Outside of school, her biggest accomplishment was being selected to sit on the St. James United Methodist Board for the youth representative position. Jenna's hobbies include reading and photography, learning about Kazakhstan, and contributing to her school and community. This year, Jenna serves as the Key Club president, where she helped organize events, manage funds, and run the program for several community outreach events. This year, she presided over the Hershey Games, Feed the Need Fund, Red Ribbon Carnival, and UNICEF Fund Drive, and the monthly teacher appreciation events. She was a member of the Putnam County Parks Recreation Volleyball Team. This year, her family had the privilege of hosting a foreign exchange student in their home. At the graduation, Jenna plans to attend St. John's River State College to earn her AA degree, then continue to the University of North Florida, or Southeastern University, to earn a bachelor's degree in early elementary education. Jenna is the daughter of Joseph and Nikki Hansford. Ladies and gentlemen, Jenna Hansford. Ashlyn Phillips, Diversified Career Technology Interlochen High. Ashlyn's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include maintaining an A average in her classes, getting personal experience in the work field, and being a good employee. Ashlyn says one of her biggest accomplishments in high school has been taking and completing 4 honors level math classes. Wow. Ashlyn's hobbies include showing cattle, fishing, riding ATVs, and being around her friends. While in school, Ashlyn has showed cows in the Putnam County Fair while maintaining her job as a cashier at Hitchcock's. She is a member of her FFA chapter. She worked on the prom and homecoming committees, and she volunteers at her church in her spare time. At the graduation, Ashlyn would like to receive on-the-job training. She would like to apply at a bank and start as a teller, and then move up to become a bank manager. Ashlyn is the daughter of Mindy and Johnny Phillips. Ladies and gentlemen, Ashlyn Phillips. Kaylin Bree Rivers, Diversified Career Technology, Palatka High School. Bree's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include being nominated for the 2018 CTE Superstar Award, participating in fundraisers for the Roadhavers Boys Ranch, and participating in the Breast Cancer Awareness Campaign. Throughout high school, Bree has participated in soccer, track and field, volleyball, 4-H, and Allied Health Assisting. She feels her biggest accomplishments while in high school have been achieving all A's for the past 2 years and becoming captain of the soccer team. She also enjoys learning about photography and her job as a receptionist at a local salon. After graduation, Bree plans to obtain her AA degree at St. John's River State College and enroll in the nursing program. Her overall career objective is to obtain her master's in nurse anesthesia. Bree is the daughter of Bill and Jimmy Westbury. Cassidy Tillis, EKG technician, Palatka High. Cassidy's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include maintaining AB average throughout the health science program for all 4 years, obtaining the following certifications: basic healthcare worker, CPR, certified medical administrative assistant, and earning her job at Putnam OBGYN. Her biggest accomplishment outside of school was learning and growing in her job as a medical receptionist. Cassidy's hobbies and interests include crafting, teaching young children, and learning more about the medical field. She has been a member of the Palatka High School cheerleading squad and the Palatka High Hosa Club, where she served as an officer. In her spare time, she is very active in her church, where she teaches children's church every Sunday morning while being active in the youth group and organizing events every month. At the graduation, Cassidy plans to obtain her RN at St. John's River State College. She then would like to further her education by becoming a certified nurse midwife. or to specialize in oncology at a as a pediatric nurse. Cassidy is the daughter of Cindy and John Tillis. Ladies and gentlemen, Cassidy Tillis. Armando Rios, Engineering Technology, Palatka High School. Armando's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include certification in Microsoft Word and PowerPoint, working on the capstone project for Georgia Pacific, and being part of the engineering class all 4 years of high school. Armando's hobbies include making music, films, going to the gym, and hanging out with his friends. While working on the capstone project for Georgia Pacific, he has been in charge of maintaining the bill of materials for the project. After graduation, Armando plans to go to the University of Central Florida to pursue a degree in computer science and then become a software engineer. Armando is the son of Donna and Luis Rios. Ladies and gentlemen, Armando Rios. Rodrigo Pina, Engineering Technology, Crescent City High School. Rodrigo's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include completing and helping other students complete projects in the engineering class. He also completed all of his required math credits 2 years before graduation. Outside of school, Rodrigo says his biggest accomplishment is learning how to play two musical instruments. Rodrigo's hobbies include music and technology. He also enjoys helping tutor the avid students. He says the engineering classes have helped him learn and prepare him to become an aerospace engineer. After graduation, Rodrigo plans to go to St. John's River State College and then transfer to Emory Riddles in order to finish his education, where he will major in aerospace engineering. Rodrigo is the son of Ernesto Pina and Anna Villegas. Ladies and gentlemen, Rodrigo Pina. Kaysen Bird, Veterinary Assistant, QI Roberts Junior Senior High School. Kaysen's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include completing the Cambridge Vet Assisting Program, receiving his FFA Discovery Degree, FFA Green Hand Degree, FFA Chapter Degree, and this year he will earn his FFA State Degree, competing in forestry career development events every year in FFA, and in 10th grade receiving the DeKalb Agricultural Award. Outside of school, his biggest accomplishment is competing in the state competition in robotics. Kaysen's hobbies and interests include camping, fishing, and spending time outdoors. While participating in FFA, he was the FFA treasurer for 2 years. He has helped with the FFA alumni rodeo concession stand, and he volunteered at Teach Ag Day at James A. Long Elementary. Kaysen has also volunteered at the Glow Run, sponsored by the Putnam Health Center. He completed many hours at the Palatka Railroad Society demonstrating model trains. And this past year, he became a very active member of the Palatka High School robotics team and participating in competitions. After graduation, Kaysen plans to go to St. John's River State College for his AA degree. He would then like to transfer to the University of Florida for a bachelor's in agriculture or mechanical engineering. Kaysen is the son of Justin and Kathy Bird. Ladies and gentlemen, Kaysen Bird. Perla Vergara, Welding Technology, Crescent City High. Perla's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include maintaining A's and B's all 4 years of high school, nominated for the 2018 Superstar, and learning new welding techniques. While in high school, Perla says her biggest accomplishment outside of school is getting a job and providing for herself. Perla's hobbies include drawing and painting. During her spare time, she volunteers at church events, the Catfish Festival, the library, the blood drives in Mr. Martin's first period as a welding tutor, and tutors in the after-school programs. After graduation, Perla plans to attend a vocational school to study auto body collisions, repair, and welding. And after receiving a few years of experience in the work field, she would like to open her own business doing automotive repair and welding. Perla is the daughter of Hasafat and Maria Vergara. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Shelby receiving the award for Perla. Kobe Foshi, welding technology at Interlochen High. Kobe's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include being nominated as one of the 2018 CTE Superstars and his willingness to be a leader in class, where he assists by tutoring other students whenever they do not understand the material. Kobe has shown leadership qualities in his ability to maintain a high GPA while working several jobs throughout high school. Kobe feels his biggest accomplishments while in high school was being nominated for the 2018 CTE Superstar Award. Kobe's hobbies include hunting, fishing, welding, and all types of sports. After graduation, he plans to continue working while attending a trade school that offers further training in welding. Kobe is the son of Cammy and Jason Foshi. Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Kobe Foshi. Nicholas Harrison, welding technology, Palatka High School. Nicholas's accomplishments in the field of career and technical education include obtaining his AWS Flux Care certification. His biggest accomplishment outside of school is starting his own landscaping business. Nicholas's hobbies include working on his truck and hanging with his friends. After graduation, Nicholas plans to continue working his landscape business and going to a technical college. Nicholas is the son of Andrea and Chris DeZoba. Ladies and gentlemen, Nicholas Harrison. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor as well as a privilege to share with you some of the criteria, some of the attributes, characteristics of this person that will be named the 2018 Tech Superstar. A strong passion and a love for agriculture education and a heart for mission would best describe this year's Career Education Superstar. For the last 7 years, our winner has been a member of the Future Farmers of America, where he has served in various leadership capacities. He has competed in numerous events with FFA and 4-H, including showing animals in the local county fair, livestock judging, horse judging, forestry, opening and closing ceremonies, tool identification, and creed speaking. He is also an active member in his 4-H club, where he has also served in the leadership capacity. He is a 4-year member of the Panther baseball team, has served 3 years on the honor guard as an honor guard at graduation, and has been an active dual enrollment student. During the summers, you can find our winner helping the underprivileged and the homeless. For the past 5 years, he has participated in team effort missions where he has had the opportunity to build wheelchair ramps, repair homes and roofs, help feed people in need, just to name a few. And when he's not on a mission trip, you will find him at Lake Cherry 4-H Camp, where he is a camp counselor to the youth of 4-H. It is no surprise that our winner plans to continue to make agriculture and helping others his top priority. After graduation this year, he will finish his AA degree at St. John's River State College and then transfer to the University of Florida to obtain his degree to be a large animal veterinarian. His ultimate career goal is to return to Putnam County and serve the community as a large animal vet. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I present this year's Career Education Superstar, Master Travis Stanley. Again, we would like to thank each of you for your support of these fine young people with all of the things that they have accomplished at such an early stage in their lives. It has taken some of the older generation longer to accomplish some of the things you've done in such a short time. Again, to all of our parents, we thank you and we appreciate every effort that you make. To our guidance counselors, we thank you. We salute you for keeping our children focused. To all of our administrators, to our superintendent, to Mr. McClellan at Seminole Electric, we thank you and we appreciate everything you do. We pray that you have a safe trip home and Godspeed.